Prince would have been 59 years old today. To honor him, the late musician's sister released this music video for her song, End of the Road. It takes fans through her and her brother's life together. That's interesting. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know that she was also a singer, so.
Right, I know, and now she's obviously coming out of the woodwork at this point and to just really say, this is my talent, and by the way, this was my brother.
Yeah. It's a good connection to have in the music industry, right? Well, we already know plenty about Prince's accomplishments, of course, in terms of his musical career.
But after his death, more and more details are slowly coming to the forefront, painting a different picture of the late legend. He was an incredible philanthropist. Zach Lajoie shows us some of the good he left behind.
Perhaps his most celebratory song, Let's Go Crazy, we'll be playing today on what would have been Prince's 59th birthday. But for Prince, June 7th was just another day. We know about his music, singing and songwriting. That all has been well documented. But there's another part of the legendary artist that we're still learning about.
But he also was an incredible humanitarian.
Shortly after Prince died, his dear friend Van Jones took to the air to tell people about Prince's humility.
He was a Jehovah's Witness, so he was not allowed to speak publicly about any of his good acts, any of his charitable activity.
Music was one way Prince helped the world, but those closest to him say he was helping the world every single day in different ways.
He supported and helped to create something called Yes We Code. Yes We Code has now 15 major technology companies working with kids in the hood, getting them ready to have jobs in Silicon Valley. That was Prince. He worked with something called Green for All. He put the money in. There are people that have solar panels on their houses right now in Oakland, California, that they don't know Prince paid for them.
Jones says when Prince would get word of struggle, regardless of the who or where, he'd send money, make phone calls. He'd do whatever he could to alleviate the pain.
He did not want it to be known publicly, and he did not want us to say it.
And according to Jones, he kept track of all his philanthropic efforts.
Y'all ready up in here?
There's so many things that he did. Those concerts that he was doing were a cover for him to be able to go into cities and help organizations and help leaders and touch people.
And that's evident here throughout his hometown. Everywhere you go throughout the Twin Cities metro, you hear stories about people he touched, institutions he helped.
He said, I don't need any more attention, but I can't be in this world and see this much pain and suffering and not do something. Don't give me the credit, don't give me the glory. But he pushed all of us to do more.
And what better of a day than today, his birthday, to celebrate not only his music, but also his philanthropy.
It's when you're having a bad day, he comes to the rescue.
That gesture is now left up to us. It's our turn to lend someone in need a helping hand, all while his music plays on.
Can I play this guitar?
That was so cool. I was just saying, remember that? When
I didn't realize it would be on camera, but I do remember that. It was so amazing. I still get chills looking at that because he was such the performer.
Interesting, and he said, can I play this guitar? I said, yes, yes, you can.
You have our permission.
Clearly.
From a Minnesota musical icon to a well-known Minnesota business.